louder, I guess. Yeah. Okay.
Thank you so much. I want to just say a few words about the next piece on the program, which is a set of four short movements for violin and piano written by Anton Webern. Some of you probably know that Anton Webern was a leading second Viennese school composer, and he, along with Schoenberg, really pioneered the 12-tone writing system. And these pieces, I think, are extraordinary. They are so full of character, and they're super expressive. And in particular, one thing that makes them so great is the extreme dynamic range of these pieces. He writes as loud as triple forte and as soft as triple piano, and sometimes he even goes to the great length of writing to play barely audibly. So it's a really unique atmosphere, and Jenny and I would just like to play for you three short examples to give you an idea of the range of this music before we play the whole thing in its entirety. Yeah, so as you can see, quite an extreme dynamic range. So we're going to go ahead and play all four pieces together now. One thing I'd encourage you to keep in mind as you're listening to this music is that maybe try to think of it like Brahms with strange notes or strange harmonies. This music is really meant to be of the utmost expression, and it definitely follows in that tradition. So we really hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
back. louder. I want to just say a few words about the next piece on the program, similarly to how I talked about the Webern a little bit. This next piece is written by Elliott Carter, and it's entitled Rhapsodic Musings. It's from a larger work of four movements entitled Four Lauds. That's L-A-U-D-S, as in to laud somebody, to praise them. And this particular, all four of the movements are dedicated to different musicians, and this particular movement is dedicated to Robert Mann. Hence, Rhapsodic Musings features his initials in the name, R-M, Rhapsodic Musings. And also, the principal motive of the piece is Re, Mi, R-M, again. So it's very clever, and so that interval is a whole step, a major second from Re to Mi, and throughout the piece, Carter brings it back in different ways. It's not always just on D and E. Sometimes you hear it on different pitches. Sometimes you hear it, the two notes together, sometimes separate, and I'm gonna play you, just like I did with the Webern, just three examples to give you an idea. Tricky, it's in the top parts of the chords. So yeah, those are a few examples. There's many throughout the piece, and there's one that is perhaps the easiest to spot at the end, but I'm not gonna spoil it, so let you discover it for yourself. So I'm gonna go ahead and play it now. It's just a few minutes long, and I'd encourage you as you're listening to this, you know, again, to think in terms of gesture. You know, this music is full of character, and he really turns on a dime and goes from something that's quite frantic to something lyrical and then something haunting and then back to the energetic stuff again. It's really a fascinating piece, and I hope you enjoy it. Thank you. Thank you so much, and thank you to all of you for coming to my recital tonight. It really means so much to see you guys here, and I really appreciate it, so thank you very much. I'd like to thank a few important people, starting with my teacher, Pam Frank. Thank you so much for always being an inspiration to me, and you know, I feel like I've learned so much from you, not just about music, but about how to lead a joyous life, and you approach music with such joy, and I feel really lucky to have been your student, and I'm really grateful for all the time we've spent together, so thank you so much. And thank you to Howard Nelson for all the work we've done together, and you've always been such a steadying figure, and you've always been so kind and generous, and I really appreciate it, so thanks so much. I'd also like to thank my studio for being the best group. Really, I feel incredibly fortunate to have been a part of such a great group of people all 4 years I've been here, and I couldn't have asked for better friends, thanks to all my friends who are here tonight and those who are watching. And thank you to everyone who flew up from home, thanks to my family, for always supporting me and for, you know, encouraging me to do this because I love it. It really means so much. And thank you, of course, to all my wonderful pianists, Jenny and Avery and Anton and Zach. Thank you guys all so much. So I think I covered everybody. I hope so. If not, you know who you are. I'm really so appreciative. And Havanaise.
Thank you.